We want to solve the given exponential equations using the properties of exponents. They're asking us to solve for x using like bases, which means we won't have to use logarithms to solve these equations. In general, if a to the power of m is equal to a to the power of n, then m is equal to n, which means if these two are equal to each other and the bases are the same, then the exponents must be equal to each other. So looking at our first equation, we have 2 raised to the power of x minus 3 equals 2 raised to the power of 5x plus 11. Since our bases are the same, and these are equal to each other, x minus 3 must equal 5x plus 11. And now we just need to solve this equation for x, and we'll have our solution. We need to get x on one side of the equation, so we need to either subtract x on both sides or subtract 5x on both sides. Let's go ahead and subtract x on both sides of the equation. This will give us negative 3 equals 4x plus 11. And then we'll subtract 11 on both sides. We have negative 14 equals, this would be 4x, this is 0. Divide both sides by 4. This simplifies, so we have negative 14 fourths equals x. This simplifies, they both contain a common factor of 2. So we have negative 7 halves equals x. Or if we want, we can write this as x equals negative 7 halves. The second example is a little bit more challenging because of this fraction. Remember, we can view this as 1 over 3 to the power of 1. And to write this so that both sides of the equation have a base of 3, we can move this up into the numerator. But remember, that is going to change the sign of the exponent. So now we would have 3 raised to the power of negative 1 all raised to the power of x plus 2 equals 3 raised to the power of 4x plus 6. Now here we have a power raised to a power, which means we can multiply these exponents. So we can write this as 3 raised to the power of negative 1 times the quantity x plus 2 equals 3 raised to the power of 4x plus 6. So finally now we have the left side and right side with a common base, which is 3. And since they're equal, the exponents must also be equal. So negative 1 times the quantity x plus 2 must equal 4x plus 6. Let's go ahead and clear our parentheses, so we'll distribute here. So we'll have negative x minus 2 equals 4x plus 6. Let's go ahead and add x to both sides of the equation. And at the same time, let's go ahead and subtract 6. This would be 0, this would be negative 8. This would be 4x plus x is 5x. And this is also 0. So now we'll divide both sides by 5. So we have negative 8 fifths equals x. Or again, if we want, we can switch the order here and write x equals negative 8 fifths. Okay, we'll look at some more examples in the next video.